Hello guys, it is Duke, and welcome back to episode number 9 of the Diamond Society SMP. Goodbye, Three Ravens. Anyways, I am on with Matt and Lolcorp right now, and I just got on. It is in the morning. Today is day number 7 of, 25 days of Diamond Society. That's pretty impressive. That's a whole week of videos, and they've all been fun, and I can't wait to do even more. Let's see. Let's see what I've done off camera. So, this is a big improvement right here. You knew the end of the last episode, or whichever. No, it was the one before when I told Ravens to come and do this for me. I told him not to do the roads that I already had started, so they were really ugly and just partially done, just sort of sticking out here. So I went ahead and I finished at least some of this part. And I got to here. And I'm like, hey, I want the military district to sort of seem above the rest of the group. And well, I did technically make it above the rest of the group by making it up on these sort of terraces, I guess. And now it just sort of feels like you're in charge when you're up here. But this is not where the average villager is going to be able to go. So, you got to feel like you're in power. I also worked on the wall over here. And I still don't have a design for the top yet, which I'll need to figure out. But you can really see how cramped it got in here. Now, what the heck? He did not quite go on this like I had laid out, but I guess I really didn't tell him. So, I'll have to change that myself. But you can really see how cramped it's going to be. And we're also going to have to fit in another watchtower right in this corner. So, this is going to be really cramped, but I might figure out something to do in here. To make it either a little bit more roomy or just nice to be in, because right now it's just not, and you feel cluttered and claustrophobic, and that's not really what I want to go with. So, let's see. I have not worked on this little pathway right here all that much. It looks really bad still. And there's Muse's house still. I put a sign there that says hashtag bring back Muse, but I cannot bring back Muse or his base because Lolcorp is preventing me from doing so. So basically, I don't think we should do anything over there until we get the okay from him, or at least we get our strength, our defensive stronger. Because, well, we do anything to Muse's base, and we got Lolcorp coming at us. So let's stay as far away as possible we can until we've got enough firepower to take him out. But I did not say that, Lolcorp, if you're listening. Anyways. I'm gonna do the storage room today, which I don't know where exactly to put yet. I'm thinking maybe like right here in the corner or something. I don't know. I'll figure it out. I've got the build laid out in a single player world, but I just need quite a bit of room to place it, so I'm gonna do that off camera, and I'll be back in a bit. Okay, guys, so I decided that instead of having it out in the commercial shopping district, I'd have it on the military district. But the size of this build, there's really no room to put it over there, so I decided to have to put it back here. Sort of out of the picture, but at least everything I'll have will be in one spot, and I'll have to worry about it anymore. And the lava is far enough away here that it won't burn. So, as you can see, I sort of went with a nice little, like, T-shape. This is where all the storage is going to be, and this is going to be the entrance. We have a nice stairway leading up. It doesn't look really good, the stairway, yet, but I'll do something about that to change that. I'm going to need lots of spruce and lots of andesite, so I'm going to probably do a quick little time lapse of me chopping down some trees when it's the morning, and I'll see you guys then. See you in a bit. think it's best if we start the outline of the structure here. We've got lots of wood, which is really all we need. And I think before that, though, we will actually just put in the floor so there's a little bit of space to walk around and you know, actually build. So, pretty simple, just going with this spruce wood slabs. I don't really think I'm going to need any detail on the floor, really. If it just doesn't look good, then I'll probably go back and change it. But for now, I think I'm fine with just having the spruce wood slabs. Because, I mean, it's just flooring, and it looks alright. It's got enough detail per block where I don't think I'm going to need to have a second block interchangeable with it. Because, you know, it looks alright. And it's a lot cheaper if I just go all slabs. So, going all slabs rather than full blocks of spruce, because that is very, very expensive after a while. So let's just place this right here. Okay. I really wanted to get this thing done a lot quicker than I am. I just had to stop there for about, I don't know, maybe an hour or so between this recording and the last recording, just for the pure fact that I wasn't able to get it done for reasons that aren't really mattering at this point, but you know, now we're working on it, so let's not take too many of those. Let's go 24. I'm pretty sure. Nah. No, it would be close. Actually, I probably won't fill it up with 21, so. Or 24. That's sad, but it's alright. We've got lots to work on today. We're just getting started. So let's finish up placing them here. Alright, so we don't need all that much. I mean, what's that, like 8? The issue is this coming in 6s, so I'm going to end up with 4 extra. That's okay. Let's just be able to place these right, though. And there we go. Okay. Now let's start working on the actual structure itself. I know the sides best. I have a picture pulled up, you know, with what I'm doing here. So, it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Just gonna have it lay across here in the center. Something like that. And up. Okay, then we want up 2 right here. Over. Up 2. Over. Up 2. 2. Over. Over. Up 2. Up 2. Over. Up 2. Up 2. Okay. So now if we take a step back and look at this, we can see sort of the shape I want out of this. And then over top of that, there's going to be a nice roof that takes up almost to, like, I think it's this level or this level where the roof stops. So it looks pretty cool. Right now, obviously, it's pretty boring, but that'll all change eventually. We just gotta finish this. 2, 1, 2. Okay, I think that's 4. Looks like 4. Move on over here. Yeah, that's 1, and that's 2, and that's 3, and that's 4. Okay, up 2, over 1, up 2, over 1, up 2, over 1, up 2, over 1. Very basic build right here. Really not too much specialty. And then, what do we do here on the top? I think we actually go across. Right here. 95% sure that's what we do. So, we're going to do that. If it's not, then oh well, it's what we're doing now. Because it's what we're doing now. Okay. So, I've been trying to get these guys to think about doing a UHC soon. And, personally, I'd love to have it to start January off. You know, start off on a good foot and good note or whatever. I don't know what I'm saying there. But I really don't want it now because of the 25 days of Diamond Society. And I don't want to miss out on that. So, obviously, I want it soon because UHCs are my favorite thing in the world. Pretty much so, at least. And I'd love to have that soon. But we've got a lot more work to be done. We've got a couple, I don't know, how many more episodes? This is episode 9, but it's actually day 7. So, you know, we've got quite a bit more to go, and I'm excited for it. It's just, I'm hoping I can keep myself inspired and at least have projects to do. I don't think keeping myself inspired is going to be much the issue as finding things to do, because, I mean, after a few things start getting built in this town, I'm not really going to know what to make. I know a few things right now that I'd like to make, you know, a blacksmith in the military district, an inn in the, I don't know where I want the inn, actually. I was thinking maybe the shopping district, because I'm like, wow, you don't shop in an inn, so I might put that in the residential. Definitely a ton of residential homes, you know, a mill and stuff like that. You know, just all that normal stuff. But it's just, don't know how I'm going to do that. So anyways, I need to find another screenshot, and I'll get back to you when I can work on this more. Okay, so for the first part of the roof here, we're going to take a lot of this wood planks, because how the roof is sloped, we can't just have stairs all the way up, plus stairs all the way up by themselves do not look very good. So this is a much better alternative to that. What we do is we come across here, we just sort of place it along, just like that, on top of this layer. And the same thing on this side. Sort of get the idea pretty quickly. I don't think those connect. I don't know, actually. I should probably have a much better screenshot pulled up than what I do right now, but I don't, so we gotta deal with this. I don't know if these ones connect either, but I'd like to think so. Again, not sure, so I'm not going to touch that. And it's that one and that one. So I know for a fact these top two ones do go all the way across. If we turn sideways, can't we go faster? Yeah, I think this is a little bit faster, actually. So that's pretty cool. Again, this really isn't too much detail to this build. But it suits its purpose as a storage place, and it's really not all that special of a build to begin with, so I guess it doesn't really matter how great it looks. The things that will matter how great it looks are like the castle itself, because that's going to be, it's going to have to be perfect, or else it won't be up to Duke standard here. Just need to place that. Come across like this. Okay, so now if we take a step back and look at this and sort of see what's going on here with the roof, you know, it looks pretty simple, and it is pretty simple, but it looks nice. We need that. We need to come over here a little bit. Place that one. Okay. There's really nowhere to go here, so we're going to have to fall. Okay. Let's take a step back and look at this. I missed one right there. Okay, let's just hop up. Okay, that looks a lot better. So again, planks all on top of the wood. Pretty easy. And on over some more. On the back side, this goes all the way across because there's no little front section like that one has. And again, to keep going up. Okay, let's do this real quick. Let's eat first, though. Starve. It's on all the way over again. I'm probably going to take out a lot of this, just edit it out, because it's really not all that interesting. It's not even interesting to place, so probably just cut the majority of this part out. But I don't know how close we're on time, so I might do some more stuff off camera, and I might do some more stuff on camera. Just sort of depends on how the time situation turns out. but let's continue this side as well. Really a simple build. Very symmetrical, so nothing really to worry about there. And we go across like this. I want to become that commentator who can take the most dull, boring things in the game and make them interesting. Because currently I can't do that. And it's very obvious. But I hope to get there someday because I feel like that's a really neat skill that a lot of YouTubers don't have. And if I could, you might be able to set me apart from the pack, you know. It would make me feel good about myself. But that only comes with practice, so even though I might not get there now or the next couple months, eventually I'd like to get there. I guess it'll just take time and effort and, you know, work and progress. It's every possible little thing that goes into completely becoming a better commentator than what I am, because right now I'd say I got the sort of concept down. I know how to make people enjoy some parts of the video, and that's a good thing because you want to keep your viewers entertained. It's just I can't do that for a long period of time, which is sort of where I start having issues. So what we need to do right now is go get some dirt. That's what we need to do. But then again, the shovel might break. Oh, well. Okay, there's some dirt in there. And then we will continue with the stairs on the back here. Pretty sure, though, if we do this right, we can just sort of... Yeah, we can just place like that. Oh, that's not where I meant to go. One right there. And then we gotta do those edges again. But actually, there is one layer below this where there's more stairs that continue the ceiling even farther down. But it actually looks really nice. So we'll see how it turns out in game because, you know, in my creative world, it looks really nice. So, you know, we're having an issue here with this sort of waterfall thing. Might have to move that. Or at least, I'm going to have to cut it off entirely, which would really suck. But let's just sort of go over this in the front with what we need to do here. We've got a level like that. And then the next level is like that. Okay, so as you can see, if you go over to the side here, it really starts to take shape because it looks nice. It's sort of, it's steep at the top and then it just sort of flows on out, which really looks nice, I have to say. Still got a lot of work on here, and I'll be back when I finish this. Alright, so we're officially done with the roof, and I say that turned out pretty well. What do you guys think? Now, I'm looking at the screenshots right now, and in these spots, these open spots, I have a whole bunch of andesite, which, it looks alright, okay, I'll make it look probably better when I start building it, but now that I'm looking at this sort of openness, I like it, but it's turning me away again, because you know what this is? This is the storage room. Now, if this was like a, I don't know, lumber mill or something, then having this openness would look 100% beautiful. But it's not, so I'm going to enclose it, and I'm sure it'll look just as good. So I'm going to do that off camera, and I'll be back when it's done. Alright, well, it's only been so long to do this, but I've finally finished, and we're on with Coop and Offensive now. Martin and Lowcorp and I have really just been on all day, so, you know, you guys have seen them before, but wow, here's how it turned out. I went ahead and really just You know, I originally had windows where all these stone are. And I was like, wow, this is gonna look weird if you can look through the window and you see the back of a chest. So I decided to turn that into stone. And actually, I think it's for the best. It looks really good that way. And I'm really happy how everything turned out. I might need a torch or so up there because it's really dark on that top layer there. But everything's all sorted out and I couldn't be happier that there's this issue. But I'm so happy everything's sorted out. You know, if I ever need to know, okay, hey, I need spruce. Let's see how much spruce would I have. If I need to run over here and get some light blue stained clay, I have it all at my disposal. And it's all here. I don't have to worry about looking through a million chests to find what I'm looking for. So I'm really happy how this turned out. Overall, I think it stands out a little bit right now, but I think once I get some more buildings going around it, it'll start looking a lot better. So thank you guys for watching. This has been Duke. Goodbye.